Right Understanding to Help Others, Part 2.
Read on.
Page 3. Heading: Help Others Equally, Whether Good or Bad.
Just look at this discovery of the intellect. Let's read.
Questioner: People live the life of helping others because it is a good thing to do, and they even tell others to do the same. But whatever he is saying for the good of others, if no one is willing to understand that he is saying this for my own good, then what about that?
Here, the intellect was used, and so the arguments have begun, and that should be done. If one does that with Dada, then the science gets revealed, and misunderstandings of hundreds of thousands like us dissolves. Here, the point of telling others: live life in helping others, and teach others to do the same. The intellect is always, the nature of the ego is such, that if some good point comes up, he will tell the other person, do this, it will be beneficial to you. Did you try it? He will say, no, I haven't started yet. Somebody told me, eat coriander and something else together, it will improve your health. After 6 months, when I inquired, he had stopped eating that and he had me start with it. So one immediately learns to tell others, live the life of helping others. We are telling others for their own good, but they don't understand that what these people are saying is for my own good. Actually, the law is, if I am already living my life helping others, then people will see and learn from that. Otherwise, it is not learned by giving sermons. However, the law of the world is very much like this. The intellect always finds such points. Do it, okay? I have learned it, now you learn it. I have seen it with some mothers who immediately make a phone call to their daughter in India. Today, Deepak Bhai had told this. It is worth doing so, okay? You take care. I just came to know about it, so I'm telling you, all right? She immediately calls. So the satsang that was getting absorbed within with great difficulty, she took it out and gave it to the daughter. So, as was the case before, she remained empty. Read on.
Dadashri, it is like this. A person who helps others isn't concerned with the other person's understanding. And if a person who helps others is concerned with the other person's understanding, then that would be considered judgmental. Therefore, the other person's understanding is not to be taken into consideration.
This is such a nice point. A person who helps others isn't concerned with the other person's understanding. He doesn't see whether the other person is good or bad, whether he is wrong, whether his intentions are bad, or whether he is unworthy. Nothing like that. Whoever I come across should definitely attain happiness. He spends his life helping others. Read on. Dada gives such a nice example. Read on.
All these trees, for example, these mango trees, neem trees, and so on, they have fruits that grow on them. So how many of its own mangoes must the mango tree eat? Questioner: Not even a single one. Dadashri: Who are the mangoes for? Questioner: For others. Dadashri: Yes. So, does it take into consideration that this person is conniving or good? Does it take this into consideration? The mangoes belong to whoever takes them. They are not mine. It is living a life of benevolence. By living this kind of life, such living beings, trees, gradually progress to a higher life form.
Dada says, the mango tree does not eat any single mango of its own. It gives it all to others. Does it take into consideration that this person is conniving or good? Does it take this into consideration? No. The mango tree says, the mangoes belong to whoever take them. They are not mine. The mangoes that grow on the tree, the rose plant gives pretty roses. People pluck them and take them. The plant itself neither smells it nor enjoys it. It is for others. By living such a life of benevolence, those living beings gradually progress to a higher life form. If we also want to progress to a higher life form, then we should use our mind, speech and body, intellect, chit and ego, and our belongings for others. If one has not attained Nyan, then this is the ultimate thing. Even if one has attained Nyan, this is actually worth doing while remaining in Nyan. Our good things, Nirma used to do this. If somebody would tell her, "This is a very nice thing you have," Nirma would say, "Take it." Same was the case with Dada. When someone would tell him, "Dada, your glasses are very nice. Is this a gold frame?" Dada would ask, "Do you like it?" "Yes." "Fine, then take it. Your watch is very nice. Here, take it." We aren't talking about being that generous, but we can spend at least 5 to 10%. Let us at least begin with 2 to 5%. If someone likes something that belongs to us, sure, take it. We will gain an experience. Oh, if we use our belongings for the happiness of others, then we also feel happy. Whereas one only thinks of his own happiness, how will I benefit? That will ultimately result in misery.
Questioner: but many a times, the person being helped blames the person who is helping him. Tathashri: yes, that is precisely what is to be observed, isn't it? Even the benevolent are rewarded with ingratitude.
Now, if one has decided on the goal, "I want to use my mind, speech and body for the happiness of others," then this question does not rise as to if he becomes ungrateful towards me. I don't have to consider that, I just have to see how I can help him. If a person throws a stone at a mango tree, does the tree think, "He is throwing a stone at me, I will not give my fruit to him"? No, rather it will give it to him first. So the benevolent nature, it is a nature of the Prakriti or non-self complex. If such a nature and aura develop in a person, then even if someone causes a loss for him, insults him, or is ungrateful to him, he continues to help that person. And some day or the other, Dada is showing us the laws of becoming happy in the worldly life. The law of moksha is, "I am not the doer, I am a pure soul." Moksha can be attained with that. Whether the Prakriti is ungrateful or benevolent, clear it and become free.
Questioner: it is due to lack of understanding. Tadashri: where would one obtain such understanding from? Page 4. If one had such understanding, then his work would certainly be done, wouldn't it? Where would one acquire such understanding from? Benevolence is in fact the highest state. This life of helping others, this itself is the entire goal of the human life.
In reality, the goal of human life. If we observe, many people just wake up and rush to go to work. They say, "I have to go to the office, I have to go to the office." When they return, some people don't even return home early from work. Why? He says, "My wife and the three children, they all keep bickering. I will reach home late by 2 hours." Can this be called life? He works overtime in the office for a couple of hours and then gets home. Why? So that half the population at home must have fallen asleep. Then I will be at peace. See, one works to get rid of his misery. He got married to become happy, but that causes misery. So to get rid of that misery, he works overtime in the office. Like that, the entire life is passing without any goal. Actually, money is not the ultimate goal in life. To get married is also not the goal. People don't know how to become happy. Dada reveals the true practical knowledge as well as the spiritual science. Read on.
Heading: in life, the important purposes are only these two. And furthermore, what is the purpose of life for the people of India? The purpose is to permanently break free from this bondage that one is in, to become absolute as the self. And if the knowledge to become absolute has not been attained, then live to help others.
He says, live to help others.
One is born in India just to accomplish these two purposes. Do people really accomplish these two purposes? Instead, people have adulterated and figured out the art of how to go from the human life form to an animal life form.
How about that? By cheating others. They have gone up to the extent of not even sparing any kinds of medicines, to the extent of not sparing food items. They are causing a huge loss for themselves.
Heading: solutions for simplicity. Questioner: what are the means to make life virtuous, sattvic and simple, saral? Tadashi: keep on giving people whatever you have with an obliging nature. your life will gradually become virtuous automatically. Have you ever had an obliging nature? Do you like the obliging nature?
Yes, Dada is asking that person, have you ever had an obliging nature? Do you like the obliging nature? Read on.
Questioner, I have, to a certain extent.
How about that? People ask, what are the means to make life virtuous and simple? Dada says, the simple way is, start donating at least 5% of whatever you have. Don't many people teach? Donate 5% of your profit. Use it for charity. Use it for feeding the poor. Use it towards educating a child. Or give a donation in some school or hospital, but start giving 2 to 5%. If you give it to others, then what happens is, sowing seeds in a farm, thousands of new seeds will grow from each seed. That will be useful in our next life. So this is the simple way to live a virtuous life. Besides, if you keep eating pure, natural food, or if you keep doing devotional viewing of God in the temple, or if you keep performing rituals or keep chanting, all that is secondary. The main thing is to help people. Read on.
Dadashri, if you have it to a greater extent, then you will benefit more. Just continue to oblige people. Get someone's work done. Run errands for others. Donate money. Have 2 sets of clothes stitched for a less fortunate person. Oblige others in this way.
Dada teaches us, in short, get someone's work done, run errands for others. Some children say, hey dad, you're going to the office, right? Can you finish this work for me on the way? See, he assigns work to his father. Hey, should we assign work to our father or should we do his work? But he assigns work to his father. It shouldn't be like that. We should keep in mind, how can we help our parents at home? Parents, charity begins from home. If we are causing trouble for everyone at home, if we are dominating them, then first do something to reduce the difficulties of people at home. And then go out and give happiness to others. But this is the right way. Run errands for others, solve their miseries. Do something that reduces their miseries. Don't do anything that will increase their miseries. Read on.
The Lord says, use your mind, speech and body, and the applied awareness as the relative self, Pratishtit Atma, for the sake of others. Page 5. Then, should any kind of misery come to you, let me know. Religion, in fact, begins with having an obliging nature. When you are giving something of yours to others, that is indeed where happiness lies. Instead, people are learning to take. Do not do anything at all for yourself. Do everything for others only. Then you will not have to do anything at all for yourself.
That is a great accomplished principle of worldly interactions. Dada reveals the accomplished principles of worldly interactions. Moreover, they are such that they touch all the way up to the level of spirituality. In reference to the original self, they eventually prove to be without any contradiction. Dada says, religion in fact begins with having an obliging nature. Use your things for others. Do not even think about yourself. Since a person's entire life is already predestined, just keep the intention, I want to help people, I want to use it for others. In doing so, if it comes in effect, then well and good. Start having the intention, then gradually we can move further. This is about improving the inner intent. Read on.
Heading, the intent should be 100%. Does any tree eat its own fruits? No. So these trees teach human beings, give your fruits to others. Nature will provide for you. The neem tree is actually bitter, yet people plant it because of its other benefits. Otherwise, they would surely uproot the sapling.
Yes, although the neem tastes bitter, why do people grow it? Because it has many other benefits. So Dada is given the example of trees. Learn a life lesson from them. Make them your guru. They use their entire body, fruits, everything for others. Learn all this from them. Learn a life lesson from them. Read on.
However, it is beneficial in other ways. It gives cooling. Its medicinal property is beneficial and its extract is beneficial. In Satyug, according to Hindu mythology, the first of the four ages, characterized by virtue, wisdom, happiness, and morality, people only strive to make others happy. All day long, the only thoughts that used to arise were, who can I oblige? It is okay if you are not able to do much outwardly, but your bhav should certainly be, I have money, so I want to lessen someone else's misery. If you have wisdom, then even by using my wisdom to explain things to someone, I want to lessen his misery. With whatever surplus you have, help others. Otherwise, at the very least, maintain an obliging nature. What does it mean to have an obliging nature? It is the nature to help others.
The nature of helping others. So how does this work? The ultimate thing is to give happiness to everyone, which was Dada's state. If you can't give happiness, then at least don't cause them misery. If you are causing misery, then do something to reduce it. If you don't cause misery, then that's the best. Otherwise, at least do something that can reduce the misery. In what way can his adversities and difficulties be reduced? And some people snatch happiness from others. The other person feels miserable, whereas he enjoys his happiness. He doesn't care if the other person feels happy or miserable. Isn't that the case with children? If the parents bring a toy for the sibling, then the other one snatches it. I will play with it. I won't give it to you. He took away his sibling's happiness. For such kind of inner tendencies in nature, we have to go all the way to the other end. No, I don't want to snatch happiness from others. In fact, we should let go of our own happiness for others. Do something that can reduce their misery. We should not hurt others, and ultimately, we have to reach the stage where others feel happy because of us. Dada says this repeatedly. At least have the inner intent. I have wisdom, money, and physical strength, so I should use that for reducing the miseries of others. Dada says, be strong in the intent. Whatever surplus we have should be used to help others. Then gradually we will be able to progress further. Read on.
If one has an obliging nature, then his nature would be so wonderful. Simply giving away money is not considered an obliging nature. You may or may not have money. However, your wish, your intention should be, how can I be of help to others? If someone has come to your home, then you should have the intention, how can I help him? Page 6. To give away money or not is dependent on your financial ability.
Yes, it's not that money is the only way of having an obliging nature. It can be through physical strength or through the intellect. We can say a few good words. We can conduct friendly worldly interactions. Or we can run errands for a person. If a person has some difficulty, we can help. I can do this for you. I'm going to the market. I will do shopping for you as well. So the other person gets that much relief. Read on.
It's not as if money is the only way to oblige others. That is dependent upon the capacity of the giver. You simply have to maintain the intent in your mind that, how can I oblige others? You only have to ensure that this much prevails. Heading, the goal of life. Through it, an obliging nature, we are able to head towards our goal to some extent. There is simply no point to a life without a goal. You earn dollars, and you eat, drink, and enjoy yourself. And you keep worrying all day long. How can that be considered the goal of life? The human life you have received, what is the point in letting it go to waste? So after attaining the human life, what should you do to accomplish your goal? If you want worldly happiness, material happiness, then you should give others whatever you have. If you give any happiness to others, then you can expect happiness. Otherwise, you will not get happiness. And if you give unhappiness to others, you will get unhappiness in return. In just one statement, understand the law of this world, of all the religions in the world. The one who wants happiness should give happiness to other living beings, and the one who wants misery should make others miserable. Give whatever suits you. Now, someone may ask, how is it possible for us to make others happy? We do not have money. So it is not that happiness can only be given through money. You can keep an obliging nature with them, run errands for them, or give advice. You can oblige others in many ways.
Although, we should not give unsolicited advice. The other person may not need it, but we keep giving it. Then that too would be a problem. A person close to us may be sharing his difficulty with us. We can say, why don't you do this? Dada says, do something so that his misery comes to an end. How can the other person get happiness? How can his misery be reduced? And the law is, if one has that heartily intention, then nature makes him instrumental in that. Read on.
Religion, dharma, does not mean sitting in front of the idol of God. Page 7. That is not called dharma. Dharma is to accomplish your goal. That is called dharma. Along with that, if you engage in any practice for concentration, then that is a different matter altogether. However, if you concentrate on this, then it incorporates everything in it. Maintain an obliging nature. Decide that, now I want to keep obliging others. Then changes will take place in you. Decide that, I do not want to engage in wildness.
What is Dada trying to say here? Dharma is to accomplish your goal. If a person keeps praying the rosary, or he keeps chanting, or he often goes to the temple, but he hurts his parents at home, he hurts his wife. But no, true religion is to move forward according to the goal we have decided. That is considered as the ultimate religion. And that concentration, some people try to maintain concentration by doing the rosary, by chanting, or by meditating. However, if we keep an obliging nature, all kinds of concentration and all kinds of religions are included in that. Dada says, maintain an obliging nature, decide that, now I want to keep obliging others. Then changes will take place in you. Dada says, whatever peace you desire by following religion or by chanting or through meditation, you will surely get that peace. And along with that, we need to decide, I don't want to engage in wildness. What is wildness? What is beastliness? To snatch things that belong to others is beastliness. To give happiness to others is referred to as humanity. If the other person causes difficulties 10 times, and yet he gives him happiness, such a person is referred to as superhuman. Whereas to snatch things from others, to snatch money that belongs to others, to have illicit relationships, Dada is referred to all that as wildness. Read on.
Even if the other person is wild, I do not want to become wild. Then it is possible for that to happen. Can it not happen?
Can it not happen? The answer is yes. Is it not possible for us to do that? Why can it not happen? Dada says, you make a firm decision that even if the other person does wildness, meaning if he snatches things from us, cheats us, betrays us, or deceives us, maintain the intention that may he not suffer any loss. This is an advanced level talk. While maintaining an obliging nature, if the other person becomes ungrateful, then how much should we oblige him? Dada says, oblige him. If a dog bites us, we should not go and bite the dog in return. We try to find a way out. However, if a human being betrays us, then we should not have the intention to betray him in return. These people are betraying us, so let's stop having an obliging nature. This is nothing but a wrong path. If someone betrays us or cheats us a few times, then the opinion to have an obliging nature is wrong sets in. Dada says, even if you get betrayed, go on with your goal.
From the moment you make that decision, would some changes take place or not? Questioner, but it is difficult. Dadashi, even though it is difficult, you can still make the decision. This is because you are a human being. Moreover, you are a human being from India. Are you ordinary? You are a descendant of the ancient sages, Rishi Muni. Infinite energies lie within you. They lie veiled. So of what use are they to you? Based on what I am telling you, if you make the decision that I absolutely want to do this, then it will definitely materialize. Otherwise, for how long will you carry on this wildness? Besides, you are not getting any happiness. Are you getting any happiness out of this wildness? Questioner: No. Dadashi: On the contrary, you are inviting nothing but misery.
Yes, Dada says, you are inviting nothing but misery. Dada says, follow my words. Here, Dada is talking to someone who has not taken Nyan. He is taking him to the right path. Make a firm decision. He says such positive things. You are a human being from India. Are you ordinary? You are a descendant of the ancient sages or Rishimuni. Infinite energies lie within you. They lie veiled, but if you do this much, then the energies will indeed manifest. Moreover, make a firm decision. Even if the other person is wild, I do not want to become wild.